We want to approximate the area under the function f of x equals 4 divided by x on the interval, on the closed interval from 1 to 5 using 4 left-sided rectangles. Let's start by marking off the interval from 1 to 5. So we're going to start here and stop here. And since we're going to use 4 rectangles, we'll use 4 rectangles of equal width. So we'll divide this into 4 equal intervals. So we'll divide it in half and then in half again. So notice how the width of each interval is 1 unit. This is often called delta x. And then to determine the height of the rectangles, we'll use the left side of each interval. So for this first interval, we'll use this function value here as the height of the rectangle. So it looks something like this. Again, notice how the height of this rectangle is f of 1. And then for the second interval, this will be the height. Notice it'll be f of 2. For the third, we'll use the height of f of 3. And for the fourth, we'll use a height of f of 4. The idea here is the sum of the area of these four rectangles will be approximately equal to the area under the blue function. Now, as you can see, it's going to be too much area, so this is often called the upper sum of the rectangles. So to keep this straight, we'll call this area sub 1, area sub 2, area sub 3, and area sub 4. So what we're saying here is the area under the function is approximately equal to area sub 1 plus area sub 2 plus area sub 3 plus area sub 4. So this notation here is just summation notation to represent the same thing. F of C sub I is the height of the rectangle and delta X is the width. So the sum of n number of rectangles will be approximately the area under the function. And notice there is a formula here to determine delta X if we need it, where A and B is the interval and n is the number of rectangles. So for this situation, the area is approximately equal to the sum of these areas, where the area of a sub 1 is going to be the height of the rectangle, which is f of 1, times the width, which is 1, plus for rectangle 2, we're going to have the height of f of 2 times the width of 1, plus for the third rectangle, we're going to have f of 3 for the height times the width of 1, plus for the fourth rectangle, we have f of 4 times 1. And then to determine these function values, we'll substitute x into our original function, f of x equals 4 divided by x. So f of 1 would be 4 over 1 times 1, plus f of 2 would be 4 over 2 times 1, plus f of 3 would be 4 over 3 times 1, plus f of 4 would be 4 over 4 times 1. So we'll have 4 plus 2 plus 4 thirds plus 1. This will be 7 and 4 thirds, or 8 and 1 third, or we can say 25 thirds. So the area under the function is approximately 25 thirds square units. And again, this would be the upper sum because we know the area is actually larger than the actual area under the function. Next, we'll take a look at approximating the area when we use 4 right-sided rectangles. And then we'll also take a look at when we use 8 left and right-sided rectangles. And I'm sure you can tell as we use more and more rectangles, our approximation will get better and better. I hope you found this helpful.